Hi there, this is Jenlo with Jenlo Designs, and tonight is the last night of my 8 Nights of Lights, and I'm working with rolled beeswax. Now, normally, you're supposed to be able to take your beeswax and roll it into a candle, but this stuff is really old, and it's cracking and splitting the minute I start in on it. So, what you can do if that happens is you can take your heated tool, put your beeswax flat, heat it up pretty good, but not enough that it melts. So when it starts to shine, stop. And you can actually tap this back together. And put that aside and let that heal. So I'm going to show you this here, that if you heat this up, until that's nice and shiny there. This is going to be real soft, and you're going to be able to roll it, and it won't crack. So just to show you the difference, this is a piece that I didn't heat up, and when I start to roll it, look, see, that's breaking already, and it won't go around. Look, see how that broke? So you have to heat it first, but that way you can use beeswax no matter how old it is. I think these pieces I have may be 5 or 10 years old. So this is the length of one, but I've used some of the top up here already. I'm going to cut it approximately in half here. We're going to make glittered beeswax tapers next. So once again, this is an old piece here, but what I want to do is I want to bring my wick out here, and because I want these to be tapers that are strung together, I'm going to cut a double length of that. I'm going to tie a knot in one end, and now I'm going to start with this here, and I'm going to heat this pretty well because I don't want this cracking. And I am on the back side. And if this were a fresh piece of beeswax, I think it would do this without me having to heat it. So I'm just going to come in here, and once I get this started, I can heat the rest of my sheet of beeswax all at once. So my wick is in there, and I've started rolling around it. And I just want to soften this so that nothing cracks as I roll it around. My camera died there. My camera battery died. So once you get this rolled up, we're just going to hit that with the heat for just like a couple of seconds, just to soften the edges, and then press them down into the beeswax. And there you have the first end of the taper. Okay, so I'm going to take the other end. I'm going to do the very same thing. Tie a knot in the end. This time, I have a piece that broke off, so that's going to be my inside corner there. I'm going to start with that. I want my tapers to work together, so we're going to come up over here. We're going to heat this. And again, I want to heat that till that's pretty shiny. And I'm going to wrap my wax around the wick there. And once I get that started, I'm going to heat the rest of this. And we're just going to go ahead and roll that up. And then I can pull this in And now I have my tapers done. So we're going to finish off the ends by simply cutting my wick off and pressing that up inside. And this one here, I'm going to pull it down a little bit. Cut that one off. And now I can pull that back down. And I feel like this isn't sticking, so I'm going to just heat set this real quick here and press that back down in there. And now I have my tapers. So the next thing I'm going to do is just take some plain spray adhesive, and I'm going to put these up here a little bit on my paper and just zap them with some spray all the way around. And for this one here, I have art glitter, angel dust, and I have some prism glitter from Judikins that I'm going to mix together because I didn't have enough of either one to do the whole thing here. So we're just going to pull those in. And I really like the prism because it's reflective, but I like the angel dust too. So these are wet, and we're just going to take and sprinkle the glitter on here and go around. And do the next one. And I want to get the top ends. And then we're just going to tap it off. And that's how easy it is to make a pair of glittered tapers. And if you check my blog out, I have them in pink and purple and turquoise as well. So once again, thanks for watching my 8 Nights of Lights. I hope you've learned a little something and had a little fun along the way.